I'm going to get down on the ground, Jimmy, if you want to come around here for the next animal.
Okay.
Because this is something very, very special indeed. These are a pair of spotted hyena. Come on, come on.
Are we going to fight each other? What's going to happen?
This is a young male, about 3 months old. He's quite frisky. This is a female, about 6 months old.
Oh, my God, what a beautiful animal.
They're beautiful. Now, they look like a dog. In fact, they're more closely related to cats, or even closer to mongoose. And, of course, they have a terrible reputation. They have a reputation for being a horrible scavenging animal, but 95% of the things that they eat, they actually kill for themselves. They're highly social. They live in groups of up to about 90 individuals. And I'd like you to meet her, because you've smelled the porcupine, now it's the hyena. So if you... If you go right down, Jimmy.
Yeah.
Come on, trust me. We've known each other for 5 minutes. Oh, yeah. Trust me.
I know what's going to happen. I'm going to end up spooning with you, and it's just going to go a different way.
Tip your head down. Tip your head down in a submissive fashion, and I'll see if she. She may want to come over. But this is a very special animal. To see one like this, and look now, chilling out on your carpet.
I mean, that's the coolest thing ever.
I mean, points out of 10, Jimmy.
10.
10.
Yeah, 10 out of 10
good
points,
man.
Yeah.
Good man.
Quills.
Look at the ears, look at the ears. And they're really intelligent,
too. Have you smelled the ears?
I haven't smelled the ears.
No, yeah, don't do it.
These animals have been tested at Duke University, and they were found to be, in some trials, more intelligent than chimpanzees.
Is that right?
Yeah. So this is an animal with a bad reputation, which is really, really beautiful.
All right, I'm gonna crawl back away.
Okay.
And then, we have one more thing.
What a thing. Let's swap over to our very last animal. Thank you very much. Come on, go.
That's fantastic.
Wow. What about that?
Thank you. These are all fantastic things. This is why I love having this job. You get to meet these fun animals.
Okay.
And they don't bite me, and it's just great, and I just...
Haven't met me yet either.
No, you're good. I'm
stay
happy.
One,
yeah,
stay one. Okay, let's have the last animal. This is a black vulture. It's come from the National Aviary in Pittsburgh. It's a great place. They teach people about all of these birds. And it's going to fly to you, Jimmy.
It's going to fly to me.
So what I'd like you to do is come around this side.
Okay.
Take your place up in the audience.
Yeah,
I'll
absolutely.
Tell you a couple of things about it. And then it's going to fly up there.
Okay,
kick
oh
your
gosh.
Nerve.
All right, good. Hello.
Hi.
How are you?
Good. How are you?
Nice to meet
you're
you.
Put your hand in this
okay, now,
okay.
These birds are really successful. There's about 20 million pairs in the world. About 10% of the population is here in the US. They will forage in families, and they will, unlike some vultures, which are purely scavengers, actually attack and kill their own prey.
Well, it won't land on anyone in the audience and attack and try to kill someone?
No. The key thing, Jimmy,
everyone
is
stays
the
still.
Legs. You see the white legs?
Yes, the white legs.
Do you know what that is?
Feet.
To cool themselves down when they get really hot, they defecate on their own legs so that as it evaporates, it cools them down. Anyway, call it over, it'll land on you right now.
Come on over, Vulture. Come here, hi.
Come on. There you go, good girl.
Oh, my God, all right. Just make sure their feet are cool. Make sure their feet are cool. Chris Packham, everybody. Oh, my goodness.